Hello everyone, I am Susie.
I am Lucy.
Today we will take you to the Kids Castle. There are many good stories and lots of fun toys in the Kids Castle. Let's go together. Hurry!
Hi, my friends. Today I'm going to read those books to you. And now let's get started. Horton hatches the egg. Horton hatches the egg. Sorry, Maisie, a lazy bird hatching an egg. I'm tired and I'm bored and liking my lad for sitting. Just sitting here day after day. It's work. How I hate it. I'd much rather play. I'd take a vacation, fly off for a rest if I could find someone to stay on my nest. If I could find someone, I'd fly away free. Then Horta, the elephant, passed my name in her tree. Hello, called the ladybird, smiling her best. You've nothing, and do I need the rest? Would you like to sit on egg in my nest? The elephant laughed. Why, of all silly things, I haven't got feathers and I haven't got wings. Me on your egg? Why, that doesn't make sense. Your egg is small, and I am so immense. Tut, tut, answered Maisie. You are not small, but I'm sure you can do it. No trouble at all. Just sit on it softly. You're gentle and kind. Come, be a good fellow. I know you won't mind. I can, said the elephant. Please, begged the bird. I won't be good nicer. I give me my word. I will hurry right back. I will never be nest. Very well, said the elephant. Science, you got insist. You want a vacation? Go off and fly and take it. I will sit on your egg and try not to break it. I'll stay and be faithful. I mean what I say. Toodle, send out the Maisie and fly away. The first thing to do, murmured Horton. Let's see. The first thing we do to do is the prop up this tree and make it much stronger. It has to be done before I get on it. I must wait a time. Wait a time. Then carefully, tenderly, gentle, he crops up the trunk to nest while the little egg slept. Then Horton the elephant smiled. He sat
all that day and kept the egg warm, and he sat all that night through a terrible storm. It poured and lightning. It thundered and rumbled. This isn't much done, the poor elephant grumbled. I wish she'd come back, because I'm cold and wet. I hope that Maisie bird doesn't forget. The Maisie by this time was far beyond reach, enjoying the sunshine way off the Palm Beach. The Palm Beach and having such fun, such a wonderful rest, she decided never go back to her nest. Next, the hunting kept sitting there day after day, and soon it was autumn. The leaves blew away, and then came the winter, the snow and sleet. The icicles hung from his trunk and feet, but Horton kept sitting and said with a sneeze, "I'll stay on this egg and I won't let it freeze." The man I said, and I said what I meant, and everything stayed for 100%. So poor Horton sat there the whole winter through, and came the springtime, it would trembles new. His friends gathered around and they shouted with glee, "Look, Horton, the elephant, up in a tree." They taunted, they teased him, he yelled, "How expert old Horton, the elephant, thinks he's a bird." Bird! They laughed, they all ran away, and Horton was lonely, but he sat on the egg and continued to say, "I mean what I said, and I said what I mean, and elephant's faithful 100%. No matter what happens, this egg must be tend." But Horton's troubles were far from end. For while Horton sat there, so faithful, so kind, three hunters came sneaking up softly behind. Then he heard the man's footsteps. They turned with a start. Three rifles were aiming right in the stare at his heart. Did he run? Did he not? Horton stayed on that nest, and he held his head high, and he threw out his chest and looked at the hunters as much to say, shoot if you must, but I won't run away. I meant what I said, and I said what I mean, an elephant's faithful 100%. But the man didn't shoot. Much to Horton's surprise, they dropped their three guns, and they started looking there with white eyes. "Look," they all shouted, "can such a thing be? An elephant sitting on top of a tree? It's strange, it's amazing, it's wonderful, new. Don't shoot him, we'll catch him. And that's, yes, we'll do. We'll take him alive. Why, he's terrible funny. We will sell him back home to a curious for money." And the first thing he knew, they had built a big wagon with ropes on the front end, the pullers to drag on. They dug up his tree and they put it inside. But Horton so sad that he practically cried, "We're off!" the man shouted, and off they all went with Horton unhappy 100%. Up out of the jungle, up into the sky, oh, up over the mountains 10,000 feet high, then down the mountains and down to the sea. When the carved with elephant nest and tree. Then out of the wagon and onto a ship, and over the ocean, and ooh, what a trip! Rolling and tossing, splash and splashing with the spray, and Horta said, they said, day after day, "I mean what I said, and I said what I mean, but I'm seasick 100%. 100%. After Bobby around for 2 weeks like a corn, they land in the town of New York. "All ashore," the man shouted, and down with the lurch went Horton the elephant, still on his perch, tied onto a board that could just squarely hold him. Boom! Harton landed, and then the man sold him. So to a curious, and then week after week, they showed him to people at 10 cents a peek. They took him to Boston, to Kalamazoo, to Chicago, Weekend in Washington, to Dayton, Ohio, State Park, Minnesota, to Wichita, Kansas, to Drake, North Dakota. And everywhere, thousands of folks flocked to see and laughed at the elephants up in the tree. Poor Horton grew sadder the farther he went, but he said as he sat in the hot, noisy tent. I mean what I said, and I said what I mean. And the elephant's faithful 100%. Then one day, the keyboard show happened to reach a town down south, not so far from Palm Beach, and sounding long way up high in the sky, all people, should chance by flying by, but that old good-for-nothing bird run away lazy, still on vacation and still just as lazy, and spying the flags wind and the tents below, she said, "Now, I will go to the show." And he swooped down from the clouds and through an open tent door. "Gutierrez," gasped Maisie, "I've seen you before." Poor Horton looked up with his face white as chalk. He started to speak, but before he could complete his talk, there ran out the noisiest ear splatting squeak from the egg that he sat for 51 weeks. Bumping, wildlife, stretching. "My egg," shouted Horton. "My egg, why is hatching?" "But it's mine," screamed the bird. She heard the egg crack. The word was all that she wanted it back. "It's my egg," she sputtered. "You stole it from me. Get off my nest and get out of my tree." Poor Horton backed down with a sad, heavy heart. But at that very instant, the egg burst apart. And out of the pieces of red and white shell from the egg that he sent. So long and so well, Horton the elephant saw something weird. It has ears and a tail and a trunk just like this. And the people came shouting, "What's all this about?" They looked and they stared, their eyes popping out. They cheered more and more. They never seen anything like it before. "My goodness, my dearest," they shout, "my word, that's something brand new. It's an elephant bird, and it should be like that." But because Horton was faithful, he said what he meant, and they sent him home happy 100%. We finish now the book. I'll see you next time. Bye.
So that's all for today. If you have nice stories or fun toys, remember to write to Susie and Lucy. We will share it with every kid in the first place. If you like our channel, remember to click on the subscription below. 首先，鲁西文，我的朋友，see you soon.